Afternoon. Can you hear me with this mask on? I will attempt to project. Welcome everyone who's both here and who's watching online. I'm Dr. Alan Baker. You're going to hear performances today from the leading tones, from the concert choir, and our tenor bass ensemble, the Husky singers. And our pianist today is the staff accompanist for the Division of Music, Mr. Ron Stabinski. So again, our first ensemble today is the Husky Singers, and we'll begin with a contemporary setting of by Michael John Trotta of an old and very famous Latin secular text, a short text by the Roman poet Virgil that simply observes that, quote, love conquers all, therefore let us surrender to love. After that, we will sing another contemporary setting of an old, well-known text, this by the 18th century Scottish poet Robert Burns. My love is like a red, red rose. The setting there is by Emily Crocker. Then we will sing one of the humorous novelty songs for which the Husky Singers are pretty well known, this one by Charles Bennett called I'm Sick of the Songs of the Sea. Sick of the Songs of the Sea. Practice saying that. And we'll have in the middle of that text a poignant narration by Brad Roth. And after that, a new setting by Robert Gibson of the well-known hymn Amazing Grace, with a solo at the opening and the closing by Allison Grimes.
Thank you. sung sailor's tears. Now we're ready to sing landlocked choruses. The songs of the sea were gigantic. They were solid, like the Titanic. They'd float for a while, but we're tired of that style. So let's throw them all in the Atlantic.
Thank you.
Thank you. We're going to next sing two Scottish Highland songs arranged for male choir in the 1990s by Bruce Trinkley for the Penn State University Glee Club. The piano accompaniments, however, were created much earlier, published in 1905 by the Scottish pianist and composer Helen Hopekirk. The first song is called Turn Ye to Me, a love song, and it will feature solos from Brad Roth and from Jacob Collins Folkert. The second song, Came Ye by Athel, is a fighting song from the failed 18th century Scottish Rebellion for Independence led by Charles Edward Stuart, better known as Bonnie Prince Charlie. Now our soloist here will be Joe Moad and Ethan Underwood. And then we'll conclude with the setting of the text Dona Nobis Pacem, Grant Us Peace, by Lee Dangler. Thank you.
The stars are shining. I have the one son, my gallant young Donald, but if I had 10, they should follow and Gary, Elder MacDonald and gallant clan. Donald, for these are the men that will die for their Charlie.
Down with the Whigamore loyal true Highlanders, down with them ready. Ronald and Donald drive on with the broad claymore over the reeks of the foes of Prince Charlie.
Thank you.
Thank you. And how about a hand for Ron? All right, our next ensemble is the Leading Tones, and this is our student-directed a cappella group. After a short COVID hibernation during the fall, I'm happy that they've been able to reform this spring under the leadership of their co-directors Tim Kirk and Dylan Garbrick, and they will announce their selections, the Leading Tones.
My name is Tim Kirk. I'm a co-director of this amazing ensemble, the Leading Tones. Dylan Garbrick, co-director. We are going to open our portion of the concert with Jake Runnestad's Nyan Nyan. This is a nonsense song. There's no language here. It's pretty much all about the range of the human voice. It's pretty exciting. It's all about like a machine wiring up and wiring down eventually. So you'll see. So that was one of four songs that we did pretty well on this semester. It's pretty challenging, and all the four songs that we've done this semester are pretty challenging as well. So these guys have done really well this semester. Dylan and I are both really proud of them. The next three songs in our program we're going to do the Spheres from Ole Yellow's Sunrise Mass. Follow that by Indodonna, arranged by Michael Barrett and Ralph Schmidt. And then we're going to close our portion of the concert with the Hymn of Axiom, arranged by Vienna Tang and arranged by Robin Salkel. Before we continue, I really want to acknowledge Dr. Baker for providing us with all the music that we use this semester, as well as a place to practice our music and a platform to perform. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you.
thank you all to all the in-person people for coming today. It's really nice to have a concert finally after not being able to have one for a year, so this is really special for all of us. Again, we are going to close our portion of the concert with Hymn of Axiom by Vienna Tang, arranged by Robin Salkel. So enjoy.
Somebody hears you, you know that, you know that. Somebody hears you, you know that inside. Someone is learning the colors of all. Say just the right thing and show that you're.
final ensemble today is the concert choir, and they're going to begin with a traditional African Hosa song arranged by Michael Barrett, and the text is a paraphrase of Psalm 23, and our drummer will be Aaron Bird. After that, we'll sing two songs of coming together. The first is the American traditional song, Down to the River to Pray, and our soloist there will be Sarah Polk. And after that, a contemporary ballad by Mark Miller, Draw the Circle Wide, No One Stands Alone, Side by Side. And our soloist there will be DJ Bell.
Thank you.
To pray. As I went down
Okay, our next two pieces are from a set of five American folk songs arranged by John Wyckoff. The first song, Look Up, Look Down, is a very sad story song about a boy, a girl, and a train. Thanks here to Aaron Bird for not only drumming, but to helping conceive of some additional percussion sounds that will be made by Dylan Garbrick. The second song is the last in the set of five, and it's called I Got a Hog and a Pig in a Pen. I Got a Hog and a Pig in a Pen. Two American folk songs.
Thank you.
Thank you. It'd be a miracle if I don't kill myself today walking on these. Now we're going to sing two songs of the night. The first, O Schöne Nacht, by Johannes Brahms. At the beginning, the men and the women alternate singing these short solo sections that describe in order the moon, the stars, the dew on the grass, the nightingale singing in the lilac bush, and then key change, and the two young lovers steal forth for a clandestine meeting. And after that, lullaby, with the words and the music by American composer Daniel Elder. And that piece will be conducted by Tim Kirk. So two songs of the night.
Thank you.
Before we sing our last song, we want to say a few thank yous. First, thank you to Abby Banz and her crew here in the Performing Arts Center for all their help, not only today, but throughout the semester. Thank you also to Bloomsburg University Administration, which bought us these lovely masks. But if you're wondering why I'm worried I'm going to fall over, they stick out. It's really hard to see your feet when you walk, right? But they're really wonderful masks made for singing, and they've allowed us to sing this year in safety. Now we want to say a tearful goodbye to our graduating seniors in alphabetical order, and I'll ask them to just come down front. We'll give them a pink cord, which is for graduation, representing the music discipline. First is Dejon Bell, aka DJ Bell. He's a mass communications major from Plum, Pennsylvania, out by Pittsburgh, and will graduate in May. He's been a member of the concert choir for 10 semesters, and in the fall he will begin work here on a master's degree in educational leadership. His favorite choir memory is when Dr. Baker, aka me, brought him Krispy Kreme donuts, which I have done more than once. He loves them. DJ. Next is Tim Kirk, a music education major from right here in Bloomsburg. Tim's been in the choir for 8 semesters. He's also a regular member and current co-director of the Leading Tones. He is leaving us to student teach in the fall, and his favorite memory has always been traveling with the choir to Scranton to perform with the NEPA Philharmonic. Tim Kirk. Not with us today, but here in spirit, Nick McWilliams. Or are you in the house, Nick? No. Nick McWilliams is a music education major from I don't know where. Anyone know where Nick's from? Shamokin. Okay. His current address is just Bloomsburg. So, anyway. Nick sang with concert choir for 5 years and was also a regular member of the Leading Tones. He also wrote a lovely piece for that group. He also writes and performs his own songs and has gained something like 2 million downloads on Spotify. I think that's a lot. He's been student teaching this semester, so not singing with us. He'll graduate next month, and he made a wonderful recording of the Star Spangled Banner that they will be using. He made it in his basement, and it sounds so good. Nick's favorite memory, like Tim's, going to Scranton to sing with the NEPA Philharmonic. He plans to apply for teaching positions in music next year while continuing to write and compose. So Nick McWilliams, let's give him a hand. Heather Rummings. Heather is a theater arts major from South Williamsport, and she will graduate in May. She has been a member of the concert choir for 7 semesters, and her favorite memory is our trip to New Orleans. Heather. And one more who is not here. Jonathan Shanley is music education and music performance major from East Stroudsburg. Jonathan sang with concert choir for 6 semesters, and he also sang with the Husky Singers for 2 semesters. Like Nick McWilliams, he's been student teaching this semester and will graduate in May. And John has been accepted into graduate programs in guitar performance at both the Peabody Conservatory and the San Francisco Conservatory. His teacher, Dr. Slotkin, thinks he's leaning towards San Francisco. I think that's a good call. Go west, young man, go west. I did not hear anything from Jonathan about his favorite BU choir's memory, so I'll just make one up and say it was getting to see me twice a week. So, Jonathan Shanley. Thank you all for coming. As one of the choir members reminded me, He's been in choir for 3 semesters, and this is the first performance. So thank you for coming. We're going to finish with a setting of Stormy Weather, arranged by Jay Outhouse.